Any brand, everywhere. Amongst all watches, Titan is a winner of the Red Dot Design Award, which is equivalent to the Oscar Award in the film world and holds the record of the slimmest watch in the world. Titan is the fifth largest watchmaker in the world, sold in 32 countries and has over 1,000 varieties catering to more than 135 million customers worldwide. Why don't you be one of them? Titan is now in Bhutan with Kushu Enterprise, the sole distributor. Visit us at Kelwang Building near Clock Tower in Thimphu. We have genuine Titan watches for all, from school-going children to office goers to armed force personnel to sportsmen with contemporary to classic designs. You can get your choice of watch at Titan. Get your Titan from Tashi Commercial Corporation in Penciling, Gelifu, Samdub Jonkhar, Paro and Thimphu, Bhutan Distributor in Penciling, Choden Songkang in Mongar, Tsering Doji General Store in Tashigang, and Royal Bhutan Army Canteen in Thimphu. A Titan watch is not only a timepiece, but also a piece of jewelry with a sentimental value. Get a jewel for yourself and for your loved ones at MRP ranging from 450 to 25,000 Neutrum. When you choose Titan, you are choosing a lifetime companion you can depend on every day and every season.
Kuzuzongpo and welcome to the season 2 of Do You Know Your Child? I'm your host, Choni. Love in action means paying thoughtful attention to what goes on between you and your children, seeing things from a child's point of view, and always remembering that this child, who sometimes may drive us crazy, is still that precious baby we welcomed into our arms with such hope. In our last show, our participant made some commitments. Let's see how well they're doing.
Last week, when I came to the show, I committed that I will eat less French fries and watch less TV. Now I'm doing that. When I came to the show, I got this watch. Thank you, Titan, and thank you to You Know Your Child.
It takes a lot of effort to fully attend to another human being. But when we are really present with our child, we often find that it energizes us and makes us feel more alive. Being close to another human being takes work, which is why 90% of people on their deathbeds say that their biggest regret is that they didn't get closer to the people in their lives. And almost all parents whose children are grown say that they wish they had spent more time with their kids. Let's see which family we have today.
Hi, my name is Dichening Zuhamo. Today I'm gonna introduce my family. She's my mother, her name is Kung Zong Wangmo, and this is my brother, his name is Rikzing Denjitopgel, and she's my small sister, she's my cousin sister actually, and her name is Pem Ringsil. And my father is not here, he went to tour. Thank you.
Welcome to Do You Know Your Child. My first question, as always, is, do you know your child?
Yes, as far as I know, okay. I pretty much know about my daughter, daughter and son.
Okay. Tell me a little something about your family.
We are four. Mm-hmm. And I have two kids.
Okay.
My daughter, she is 7 years old, and she goes to Dr. Thogill School.
Okay.
And my son, he's 3 years old.
Okay, all right. Do you work, La?
Before I used to work,
okay.
Then I left recently, mm-hmm. because there is no one to look after my son,
okay.
So I have to leave.
And did you even consider maybe your husband leaving the job, or was it just something that you thought, and you, like, as soon as you found out that there's no one looking after your son, was it automatically you, or did you even discuss this with your husband?
No, it's my choice only, because I think mother and father comparing, I think mother knows how to look after their kids.
I see. Okay, all right. And I think that's a big sacrifice. Did you enjoy your job?
Yeah.
I see. Yeah, see, I think it's a big sacrifice that, one of the many big sacrifices that mothers give.
Yes, la.
And kudos to you, saluting you for being that mom who gave up. I think people say women should not give up jobs to stay home and look after their kids. But I think as long as women are given the opportunity to choose, they don't have to stay home and look after the babies. They shouldn't be made to work in the office. I think they need to have options, right? And I think you got that. You made a very wise decision, and you decided to be a stay-home mom.
Yes, la.
Are you enjoying that?
Yes, la. I'm really happy about it, la.
That's
and
really
I'm enjoying
good.
It, la.
Okay. And my future plan is when and if I have babies, I think I want to be a stay-home mom too, because that way I'll be able to connect with my child more and give my principles and values to my child. All right, that's really good. Okay, so tell me a little something about your eldest daughter.
She is 7 years old.
Okay.
So she goes to Dr. Topkil, and then she is fun, loving, caring, and at the same time, she is a little naughty also.
Of course.
Yeah,
what are normal?
Normally kids are really naughty.
Yes. I think that's important. For me, what I always tell children is that it's okay to be naughty, but it's not okay to be bad, right?
Yes,
so I think when they're naughty, they get curious, they find out more.
Yes.
I think I'd rather have a naughty child than a dull, quiet child, because they don't find out anything on their own.
Yes.
So it's good that she's naughty, and I'm really excited to meet her. But before that, let me explain to you the rules. I'll ask you 10 questions about your daughter.
Okay.
And then after you finish answering them, I'll ask your these questions to your daughter.
Okay.
And after she answers, we'll tally the answers that you both gave, and then that'll be your score. Okay? All right. So are you ready for your question?
Yes.
First question. Okay. What is your daughter's favorite color?
Kids, they keep on changing their colors.
I agree.
Yes. Recently, she chose pink. No, I think it's blue.
Oh, okay, all right. Question number 2. What is her aim in life? Does she have an ambition?
Yes.
Okay.
I think she wants to become a singer.
Oh, okay, all right. Does she sing a lot?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. I'm going to make her sing later. Question number 3. Who dresses her in the morning to go to school?
Mila.
Okay.
Myself.
Next question. Who prepares her for her examinations?
Oh, myself.
Okay. Next question. Does your child help you in the kitchen? I know she's young. She's 7 years old, but...
But no.
Does she help you with the
I make sure that whenever she eats, I make sure her plates, to carry her plates to the kitchen. Plates and mugs and all.
I see.
Small things.
So you don't do that for her?
No.
She has to do it for herself. Okay. Anything else? Any household chores that she helps you in?
No.
Okay. Next question. What is her favorite channel?
Disney.
Okay. Next question. Does she get along with her friends?
Yes, pretty much.
Okay. Question number 8. What outdoor games does your child like to play?
Swimming.
Okay. Second last question. Do you think your daughter would know who the 4th king of Bhutan is?
I think she knows, but she don't know the name.
Okay.
But looking at the picture, she knows that he is the 4th king.
Okay. So you don't think she would know the name?
Name, yeah.
Okay. Last question. Do you think your daughter would know where the 4th king was born?
No.
Okay, all right. Well, you've answered all the 10 questions very confidently. Now we'll have your daughter come here and she will answer these questions for us.
Okay.
All right, the Chen, right?
Yes.
Okay, the Chen, welcome to Do You Know Your Child. Before anything, could you please introduce yourself?
My name is the Chen Ning Zilhamo. I'm 7 years old. My class is 3, and My school is in Dr. Dolke School. My section is C.
Okay. All right. I like section C's because you know why? My name starts with C, right?
Choni.
Yes, Choni starts with C. And also, I was the class teacher for 3C and 2C at Druk School. So you're also in 3C, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, excellent. Okay, Dichen, I asked your mother 10 questions about you, okay? Mostly about you. I have the last two questions about someone else, but I'm going to ask these questions to you. Dichen, before I ask you these questions, tell me something very interesting about you.
I like dolls and I like reading books.
Wow, I can tell that you enjoy reading your reading books because you're very good when you talk. You're very clear, which is very important. So keep it up, okay? Keep reading. It's good habit. I also heard from your mom that you enjoy singing.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, what's your favorite song?
My favorite song is One Thing.
One Thing? Who sang One Thing?
One Thing.
You don't know?
I don't know, ma'am.
Why don't you try and sing it?
I also know Frozen song.
Okay, so which one's the most favorite song?
Frozen song.
Okay, Frozen song. All right. Can you sing it for me, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Please, thank you. Go ahead.
The snow goes down to the mountain tonight at the footprints I could see. So I'd listen. The good side and the queen. The world is howling when the world is born alive, it has no died tonight. Don't let them in, don't let them be the good girl. Woman have to be if you don't feel, don't let them know.
Oh. Well, now they know.
Let it go, can't hold by anymore. Let it go, let it go. Diddly and
the door.
Let the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Only this much, ma'am.
All right, well sung. Okay, that's really good. You're going to continue singing to Dukush. Do you enjoy singing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so keep singing, keep reading. These are really good habits. So good?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now are you ready for your questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, number one. What is your favorite color?
My favorite color is blue.
Next question. What is your aim in life, which means what is your ambition in life? Do you know what ambition is?
No.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a doctor.
Oh, okay, all right. Next question. Who dresses you in the morning?
My mother.
Okay, next question. Who prepares you for your examinations?
My mother.
All right. Next question. Do you help your mother with any kind of work, household work?
Yes.
Okay, good. Now, what kind of work? How do you help her?
Washing clothes.
You wash clothes?
Huh? Yes, ma'am.
And what else do you do?
Only this much washing.
Okay, all right. Next question. What is your favorite channel?
My favorite channel is Doraemon.
Oh, okay. So now that is a show in one of the channels. But channels are like, let's see, Nickelodeon is a channel, okay?
Yes.
Then there is Disney.
Yes.
Then there's Cartoon Network. Yes. So from all these, which one do you like?
Disney.
Okay, Disney, all right. Next question. Do you get along with your friends?
Yes.
Okay, that's very good, okay. So question number 8. What is your favorite game outside, outdoor games?
Rackets, ma'am.
Okay, second last question. Do you know who the fourth king of Bhutan is?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Jimmy Singye Wangchu.
Excellent, all right, and your last question. Do you know where he was born?
Yes, ma'am.
Where was he born?
The Chilling Palace.
All right. Excellent. That's good. You've answered all the 10 questions. Let's take a look at your mother's score, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
What is your daughter's favorite color?
Blue.
Blue.
What is her aim in life?
A singer.
Doctor.
Who dresses her in the morning to go to school?
Mila.
Mother.
Who prepares her for her examinations?
Me.
Mother.
Does your child help you in the kitchen?
Yes.
Yes.
What is her favorite channel?
Disney.
Disney.
Does she get along with her friends?
Yes.
Yes.
What outdoor games does your child like to play?
Swimming.
Rackets.
Do you think your daughter would know who the fourth king of Bhutan is?
Don't know the name.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you think your daughter would know where the fourth king was born?
No.
The Chilling Palace.
Let's take a look at the questions your mom wasn't able to answer correctly, okay? Your mom said you wanted to be a singer because you're a beautiful singer. Your mom thought you might want to grow up and be a singer. Now, who's right? Do you want to be a singer or a doctor?
Both of them.
Both, yes, you can be a singing doctor, right? Right? Don't you think so? We have actresses who are teachers, right? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
We don't have a doctor who's a singer, so we'll have you as the first one. Tupka, do you want to be a doctor who sings?
No, ma'am.
No. Why? I think if, you know what, if I have a, let's say if I have my, if I have a stomachache, and I go to the hospital and my doctor is singing, let it go, right? I would love that. I don't think I'll even need medicine.
Ma'am, I think it's so funny.
But that would make people laugh, which means you're making people happy. But I mean, you can either be a single or a doctor or both if you want, okay? Only if you want. Tupka.
Yes, ma'am.
So now what do you want to be?
Singer.
All right, okay. Then I'll see you singing and getting very popular in Bhutan in a couple of years, okay? Then your mom said that you like swimming out as your outdoor games, but you said you like badminton, right?
Yes.
So I couldn't give a point for that. Then your mom said you might not know the name of the fourth king, but you knew. So no points for that. Your mom also said you might not know where the fourth king was born, but you knew. Your mom didn't get the point, but I know your mom is very proud of you. Although she didn't get the point, she's very proud of you, okay? For knowing the last two answers. The question. Okay, with that we have your score as 6 out of 10. Is that a good score?
Yes, I think so.
Yes, I definitely think 6 is a great score for this show. Tukush?
Yes, ma'am.
So now that we have taken a look at the score, let's go on to our next segment, which is the commitment segment, okay? We'll start with Mom. Do you think there is anything you need to change as a mother? Is there any improvement that you have been meaning to make? Any step that you've been wanting to take, but you never got the time to sit down and say, you know what, here on I'm going to do this?
Yes, I think I have to listen to her sometimes. Love.
I see, okay. During our times when we were kids, our parents never sat down and listened to us, right? I'm sure you know, you understand that. But now the kids are very verbal and they want to talk, they want to be listened to. So I think just to listen to them would
But I think kids want everything. They want to go to Disneyland, they want everything.
That's true. So your mom said that she will listen to you more, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
I think that's a very good commitment on from a mother. Tupka. Dichen, for you, I have your mom gave me 3 commitments. Tupkush. So now I want you to pick one. Your mom says if she could read her storybooks herself. Does your mom help you read?
Yes.
Okay. Do you enjoy reading yourself?
Yes.
Okay. Do you read yourself?
Yes.
Sometimes?
Yes.
Okay. I think your mom wants you to be a little independent about reading. Tupka, independent means doing it yourself. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, do you think you could do this?
Yes.
See, all I'll try.
Yeah. I think the best thing you could do is try. Tupkush?
Yes,
if you don't try, you will never succeed in life. Tupkush?
Yes, ma'am.
If you don't try to pass, you will always fail. Imbagush? So if you don't try this, you will never be able to read. And when if you go to class 12 in the future and you're still asking your mom how to read this, that's embarrassing, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So you try and read it yourself. Of course, if there are new words, your mom can always help you. Topka?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, all right. Well, now let's move on to our next segment, which is with love. Your mom will read her letter to you first, though.
My dear Dichen, when did you become an almost 7 years old? You are and will always be my baby, my angel. I still remember the day you were born. It was the first snowfall of the year. Thank you for being my inspiration. Always remember to be brave, bold, and courageous, because you are meant to discover, to create, to learn, to experience it all, and Mama and Appa will always love you every step of the way, no matter what. I wish and pray that let your dreams take you as far as they can go. And always keep in mind, I'm not only a mother, but a friend, and hope to be a best friend forever. With lots of love, Mom.
From the letter, it says that you were born on the first snow day of the year. Is that true?
Did she don't know. So
you know what? You can tell your friends. You can go to your school and tell your friends that, you know what? I'm just like Elsa. I brought the snow.
Yeah, you're like right? A Frozen.
Do you like Elsa from Frozen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, and she brought the snow, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So you brought the snow in Thimphu. Is it in Thimphu?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, Imbe, you can tell that to your friends. Imbe, do you think you want to tell that to your friend or no?
No, ma'am.
Now it's your turn to read independently, all by yourself. You can read.
Dear Mama, I love you very much and you are too good and kind. I know you also love me a lot. You know, one day I was crying in my bed. Your good night voice stopped me from crying. Mama, you are so beautiful. You take care of me. When I grow up, I'll take care of you. When I grow up, I want to be as beautiful and kind like you. I love you this much. I will show a heart for you, Mama, because I love you and I will love you forever.
I love you this much. How much? You didn't show us how much.
This
much. Oh, that's a big heart. Okay. All right.
Thank you.
You are such a good writer. I like how you went in the past and told your mom about how one day you were crying and your mom's voice stopped you. She said goodnight.
Yes, ma'am.
And that stopped
you. She goes to her bed in her own room.
Okay.
And then I have to read her storybook before she goes to bed. And then sometimes she watches horror movies and all. And then I think she cries in the bed.
And I am so much older than you, I still cry, huh? Why do you watch horror films? I don't think it's wise.
It's also all in Hindi, South Indian, totally South Indian movie, like Chandramukhi and all.
Why do you watch them?
Because they're too interesting.
Interesting. Yes. All right. Just a piece of advice. I don't think you're ready, your brain is ready to understand horror films, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
I know we can all have different interests. You might enjoy a horror film, but right now you get scared, Imbe?
Yes, ma'am.
But try and stop yourself from watching horror films. Stop.
Yes,
just one
ma'am.
Piece of advice from Ma'am Chuni. Topka.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much for reading your very, very, very well-written and very sweet letters. Now that we've come to the almost end of the show, I have these books for you, my dear. I definitely want to mention this book. Could you read the top title?
His Majesty Jimmy Singeonchu.
Yes, and he's the
fourth
king. And it says, the king who gave everything. And because I told you it's a very special year for our fourth king and for all the people in Bhutan, I want you to read this and know more, okay, about the fourth king. Topka.
Yes.
And with these, I have, you know what's inside, right?
Yes.
This is a very popular gift, and do you know your child, right?
Yes.
So you deserve this, and there you go.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're very welcome. All right, with this, I want to thank both Kinzang and the Chen for coming here as a team and playing this game. Did you guys have fun?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Thank you so much, both of you.
Thank you so much, La.
It isn't enough that we tell our children we love them. We need to put our love into action every day for them to feel it. Come back next week, and if you'd like to be a part of the show, or if you have any suggestions or feedback, please email us at parenting@bbs.bt. Thank you, and bye-bye.